Heads, this is Olin from What I'm Listening To. For today, I'm feeling a little bit nostalgic, and I wanted to dedicate a video by going down memory lane a little bit. Specifically, I want to talk about the first albums I ever bought from AMOEBA San Francisco. As most of you already know, AMOEBA is one of my favorite places of all time. I'm constantly going there. I live pretty damn close to it, all things considered. Part of the reason I moved to San Francisco is because of AMOEBA, and I've purchased virtually all of these CDs at AMOEBA San Francisco. But there are three CDs that exist in the collection here that are the first things I ever bought on my very first trip at AMOEBA San Francisco. They're kind of like the holy trinity of CDs as far as AMOEBA collection stuff goes. So before I get into what those CDs are, let's set the scene a little bit. It's 2012, I'm 18 years old, going on 19. I just graduated high school. I'm still working at my dinky pizza job, but I'm on the verge of quitting and moving on to the first coffee shop I ever worked at. And I'm still the big music fanatic that I am today. I don't have quite as extensive of a CD collection as I do now, but I definitely was starting to build one. All the CDs I had were the core things that I liked. I was still on the hunt for new stuff, mostly in the rock department, not quite in the experimental department. That came a little bit later. And at the time, the only place I could really get CDs were at Target or Best Buy, back in the day when Best Buy actually had a pretty decent CD collection, as well as just online resources like Amazon or eBay. I didn't even really know about Discogs by then either. Then one day, one of my coworkers asked me, "Hey Olin, have you ever heard of the place AMOEBA? I think you would really like it." He then went on to describe it's a record store in San Francisco. It used to be a bowling alley, but now it's just this big hub full of CDs, full of DVDs, vinyl, all the music that you could possibly imagine. I was intrigued by this place, but at this time I had no interest in going to San Francisco. Funny enough, back in those days, I hated San Francisco. I hated the idea of the city. I thought there's too many people, it's too overwhelming. There is no friggin' way I'm going anywhere near San Francisco. Now, fast forward about a year, my brother, my dad, and I are taking my mom to San Francisco International Airport. And after we drop her off, we're driving back, and my dad suggests, "Hey, let's go to that AMOEBA place your friend was telling you about." And I figured, why the hell not? We're at San Francisco, so let's go. So we get to the Hate District, we park the car, we walk over to the shop, and the moment I set foot in it, I was blown away. I was flabbergasted. No words. I could not fathom what I was seeing. My friend was not wrong about the amount of CDs that were there. It was the most CDs I'd ever seen in one building. And from there, I went on this mad dash going from section to section, looking at what they had, trying to think of bands that I wanted to see if they had albums by, seeing what they had, being blown away by the fact that they had a CD by this band here and not at Best Buy or any of my other resources I was using. And this went on for probably about an hour. And by then, it was starting to get a little late, and my brother and my dad virtually had to drag me out of the shop because I was still going. I probably could have kept going for several hours at that point. But we had to leave, so I went to the checkout with the three CDs I'm about to talk about here, and I'm hooked. The rest is history. I kept going back. I kept bringing list upon list of stuff to look for. I would make special trips from my hometown to San Francisco to see what AMOEBA had, and now here I am in San Francisco, still going, still buying CDs, and it's all thanks to my friend who suggested AMOEBA in the first place, And that one trip alone did it for me. So now that you know the story, let's jump into what those purchases actually were. And the first album of that bunch, I have Sum 41's All Killer, No Filler. The funny thing about this album is it seems to be one of those albums where everybody who was in high school was listening to it. They grew up listening to it as a teenager. I guess you could say I was kind of late to the party with this kind of stuff. I listened to a little bit of pop punk when I was in high school, but I was mostly into the kind of alternative metal, post-grunge sounding stuff. Stuff like Breaking Benjamin, Red, a little bit of Nickelback, those kind of crappy bands. But I certainly did know about Sum 41. And more specifically, I was aware of the song Fat Lip, thanks to the very first Guitar Hero. I don't wanna waste my time, become another casualty of society. I loved the melody, I loved that iconic opening guitar riff. I had an MP3 of it on my iPod that I may or may not have acquired legally. And of course, it was a pretty poor quality sounding MP3. So finding this album was an opportunity for me to get a better quality sounding song, along with hearing the rest of the stuff on the album. I really had no idea what any of the other songs sounded like. I only knew Fat Lip. And I bought this CD because it was there. I had never seen it anywhere else in any of the other places I'd been to. And best of all, it was only like $2.99 or $4.99. That was one of the beauties of AMOEBA that I discovered. You could find so many great gems like these for such an inexpensive price. You'd be stupid not to buy stuff like this. And funny thing, there's actually two copies of this album that exist in the collection behind me. This one right here, the one I bought at AMOEBA, and my girlfriend's copy that she had when she was growing up. Neither one of us can get rid of our own copies because they hold such sentimental values to us, so we've just stuck with hanging on to both of them. Probably we'll never get rid of it because obvious reasons. It's one of the first purchases from AMOEBA. Cause I'm in too deep and I'm trying to keep up a thought in my head. Instead of going under, instead of going under, instead of going under. The second of the three albums I have for you today, I have Everclear's Songs from an American Movie Volume 1. In line with buying All Killer No Filler for Fat Lip, I bought this album specifically for the song Wonderful. I had a copy of one of the early, now that's what I call music volumes. I want to say it was Volume 5. It could be 4, I don't remember. I'll have to look it up and I'll put it here on the video. On that compilation had the song Wonderful. And I remember listening to it over and over and over again growing up. It's funny because at the time, I had no idea that song was about parents separating. I just really liked the melody. I liked the kind of poppy nature of it, but also it being really heavy. And I also liked Art's vocal delivery. So because of that song, I knew about this album. But again, I didn't know where I could acquire a copy of it. So when I found it at AMOEBA for only $2, $3, $4, I can't really remember. It was cheap, I can remember that. It was a no-brainer, I was buying it. Some days I hate everything, I hate everything, everyone and everything. Please don't tell me everything is wonderful now. Aside from this being such a token 90s post-grunge, pop rock sounding album, it's actually really, really good. Not only is Wonderful the highlight track on here, but there's some other great stuff on here. Unemployed Boyfriend was one I really liked, Annabella's Song, Learning How to Smile, The Honeymoon Song. There's some really good stuff on here. Eventually down the line, I picked up the album sequel, Volume 2, at AMOEBA, actually. I think that came a little bit later just because I could never find a copy of it every other time I went, but I got it. But between the two, this one is easily my favorite. There's some great stuff on here. Anytime I want to listen to something angsty yet melodic, I will usually put this record on. It's so, so very good. And I'm so very happy AMOEBA had a copy of it because I don't know where I would have found it anywhere else. Probably at a thrift store if I went in there, but glad I was at AMOEBA. Hey, you can be with me. Yeah, cause I just might be the one who will treat you like you're perfect. And the last of the three albums I have for you today, Internet, I have Coheed and Cambria's In Keeping Secrets of Silent Earth 3. This album is the very first Coheed and Cambria album I ever listened to in full. And the interesting thing is, at the time I got this album, I wasn't even sure I liked this band. Like a lot of fans, I had heard the song Welcome Home thanks to Rock Band 1, and I loved it. I loved how heavy it was, how epic it was, how just big it was. It's a fantastic song. But anytime I tried to listen to any of their other songs off that album, I just couldn't get into it. It just didn't seem heavy enough, it didn't seem epic enough, it just seemed pretty mediocre. And I tried over and over again to like their material. I'd listened to that album several times, I'd listened to some of their later stuff just to see, well, maybe this stuff's heavier, and I just couldn't get into it. It just wasn't doing it for me. Around that time too, I had a friend who was a mega fan of Coheed. And he hit me up and said, hey, they're gonna be playing in San Francisco, do you wanna go? And even though I didn't really like the band all that much, I agreed to go to the concert because it was an opportunity to go see a show and to go see some live music. And during that first trip at AMOEBA, I had my ticket. I was gonna go, the show was right around the corner, and I needed to prepare myself. So I perused through the selections of albums they had by Coheed and Cambria at the shop, and I picked this one specifically for the song A Favorite House Atlantic. Good eyes, sniper. You know I shoot and you run. The words you scribbled on the walls with the lots of friends you didn't have. That same friend had sent me that song, and I actually kinda liked it. It wasn't quite as heavy as Welcome Home, but I liked how fast-paced and melodic it was. In fact, I think I might have even described it as sounding like an anime opener. I was kind of a weeaboo at that time, whatever. So they had this album for, again, $4.99. Couldn't pass it up. And I grabbed it. And I am so glad I did, because this album very quickly became my all-time favorite Coheed and Cambria album. Not only is A Favorite House Atlantic a fantastic song, but there are so many great cuts on here. The title track is amazing. Cuts Marked in the March of Men is probably my favorite tune off of here. The Crowing is fantastic. The Light and the Glass is great. And best of all, there's even a hidden track on here called 2113, which I love. It's just extra content. So I listened to this album over and over and over again in preparation for the concert. I even went and I bought Coheed's very first album and the album that has Welcome Home on it. But ultimately, I kept going back to this one just because I was so addicted to it. At that show, they didn't really play many of the songs off of this album, which I shouldn't have been shocked because this is their second album. It's older material. Bands are going to be playing their newer, more relevant stuff, whatever. But I did have the privilege of seeing Coheed and Cambria live again to celebrate the anniversary of this album, and they played it in its entirety. So I heard everything off of this, all my favorite songs off of this album, live. It was phenomenal. I think that show was one of my favorites. This album is so good. I love it so much. I'm probably never gonna get rid of it. It's gonna be in my collection forever, or as long as it still plays. Big thanks to AMOEBA for having it in their store that particular trip, because I don't know where else I would have gotten it otherwise. Then why should I spend any more time in a world that's gonna end? Alrighty then, Internet, that does it for me. So instead of suggesting other bands or albums you want me to check out, I encourage you all to tell me about your first record store experiences. If you have them, what were they like? What was the shop? What did you buy, if you can remember? Leave that all in the comment section down below. I would love to hear your stories. And if you also like this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button. It'll show me the support and I'll love your face for it. And you can also follow me on Instagram for even more music. I post a new album on there semi-frequently, talk a little bit about it, and it gives you a bit of an insight of what else is in my collection. So, thank you all very much for watching. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To, signing out. Goodbye. Oh fuck, I'm still recording.